Okay, here we are, Kerbal Space Program Level 4, heading back to the space station. Here is my new module for the space station. I call it the power plant. It's a lot of solar panels and a lot of juice, and I just stacked it full of crap, basically. As usual, I designed my module pretty shitty, like, not symmetrical, very heavy, not balanced right, long, wobbly, just generally shit. Like usual. This is the problem, right? I think, oh, I can design a cool rocket to lift it up because I'm clever enough to make a powerful rocket that will lift this heavy thing. And that's all well and true. I do design clever rockets that can lift heavy things, but that doesn't matter. Once I'm in space, heavy things are still hard to move around. And even though this thing has a retarded amount of monopropellants, thinking again that I was going to add fuel to the station. I do add fuel this time, but I just didn't balance it well. I really haven't mastered in space flight yet. Not really good at spinning out of control. Not really spinning out of control. Rotating, like the pilots would be just throwing up inside the cockpit with how fast this rocket's spinning. Because it's so long and wobbly, because there's this giant tower on top of it that's new piece of the space station. Yeah, so it's easy to design a rocket that can lift this. Like, that's not the hard part. That's the easy part, really. The hard part is maneuvering this piece to the station. Oh, why did I make it so complicated and stupid? I really need to make smaller, more logical pieces. For my next project, my interplanetary cruiser, probably, I'm gonna plan much better and not make so much crap. It looks kind of cool and looks like a space object, but it's pretty much shit. I mean, look at it. It's got fuel sources on the end. It's light in the middle. Like, it's such a dumb design. I don't know. It looked cool. That's why I liked it, because it looks like this massive tower. Again, I didn't put my RCS thrusters in good positions. Just working out my intersection with my satellite. I'm getting a shadow orbit where I follow it inside so I can catch it up. I have an orbit that's smaller than my space station, so I will circle it faster. And then I just time-lapse. I edited this down a lot. The raw footage of this mission was like an hour and 45 minutes. This is cut down and hyper-speeded to the point of insanity, because it's just not that interesting. Docking at the space station was impossible because this thing was such a lumbering beast. I couldn't move laterally, so I had to approach my station pointing docks to docks. So what I had to do was like circle around my station until I came to the spot where I wanted, and it took me forever because I moved incredibly, incredibly, incredibly slow. This part here was like maybe a half hour of slowly crawling towards my station because I knew that I couldn't move laterally, so I had to be lined up with the port in my approach. Like, I had no way to correct, because the way my RC ports are set up, they just can't move me. They're really crappily designed. Like, I really designed this rocket really crappy. And my moving rocket, okay, so the mission here is, I forgot to say what our mission is. Level 4 mission, move to space station, add modules, swap out crew. Very important part. We're gonna bring the guys home, and we're gonna put in new guys. I believe Jebediah, Bill, and Bob, the three amigos, the three musketeers, are in there as we speak. So I'm going to swap them out for these new guys, which are, I can't read them on the previewer because it's too small. But I know they're different names because I traded until I got new guys. And docked. Oh, not docked. I bumped into it and it bounced off. So I just quickly thrusted into it again, hoping the magnetism would grab this time, because I knew that I had no way, like, there's just no way. If I failed that time, I would have just scrapped the whole mission. If I hadn't have connected that time, I would have completely scrapped the mission. I set up my action bars beforehand. If you notice, with one button, I turned everything on the satellite on. That's a cool thing about action bars. You can do that before in your vehicle assembly building. You can add basic hotkeys to toggle stuff on your ship for you. So it's really cool. All right, now I'm doing my spacewalk. I gotta move the three guys out of my landing ship that I just brought up with the new module. Oh, I hit the station. He wobbles. Poor guy. I probably would have killed him right there if that was a real man. Because I hit him into the station and he, like, spun out of control. So I'm going to put these guys in the lower life support one. That middle one has the crew in it already, so I don't get them confused. All right, one guy's going to go into the command module, though. Because I never left the dude in the command module last time. I think this is Lemmy. Lemmy is going to go into the command module so that they can pilot it. Because right now, with no one in the command module, that means the probe is piloting the space station. Which is fine. All it really does is keep it from just maybe oscillating out of control or something, I don't know. But either way, I like having a pilot. So, and plus, I figure if he's in that little room by himself, he gets the three-man pod all to himself, and then the two guys get the four-man pod to themselves, so they have more space. All right, so Lemny is in the command module, or Lemny, I don't know how you say that guy's name. I think this is Gus. I'm going to bring over Gus now and put him in the lower life support chamber. I have to go around the solar panels because I'm afraid of bumping into him, so I drift way out into space every time, which just makes this maneuver especially scary because I put ladders all over the station to accommodate spacewalks, and then I put these giant solar panels in, like, the middle of my station. Like I said, this station was cool and fun, and I really liked doing it. But I'm going to probably only come back here to swap crew. I don't think I'm going to add anything more to this station because I just don't like it. It's not designed well. It's just not designed well. And that bothers me. Like, it bothers me a lot. All right. I think everyone's swapped over. Yep. Okay. Everyone's in the space station now. So now I'm going to bring the three guys. Good old Bill, Bob, and Jebediah are coming home, baby. You're coming home. You don't have to stay in the station any longer. Oh, Jebediah, you're so excited to be coming home. You've been up there for, let's see, two moon trips, so at least a month, maybe more. I don't know. I don't know how the game time works here, because since career mode doesn't work, there's really no stats. Like, you don't know anything about your guys. Like, I don't know. I imagine this is all going to be worked out in the future, but as of right now, you don't really know anything about, like, how long your guys are in space or if they die or not, because sometimes I think that they should have died. Like, when you're going to other planets and you just take the command module, like, there's no way. Those guys couldn't survive that. But especially when you take one dude and that tiny little command module, like, that module is basically just a seat. Like, that's essentially just a chair surrounded by metal. And he's gonna sit there for like a year while you fly out to another planet? Give me a break. He would have died. No question he would have died. Blood clot in his leg killed him. Whatever. I don't know. All right. Station docked. I lost my targeting there for some reason. It went to my satellite. That was like my first satellite, if you remember. That one's out of juice. It doesn't even move, so it's just stuck like that forever. All right. Back to the station. I'm gonna decouple. Move away from the station. I have a retarded amount of fuel, so there's really no worries. I left as much fuel as I could on the station, but the station hasn't really refueled anything, so there's nothing empty. There was no fuel to put in it. Otherwise, I would have dumped as much of that fuel in the station as I could have. But all the tanks are full on the station, so because the only tanks there are the two escape pods and then that emergency, or that fuel tank I just brought up. And that was obviously full. I didn't use it. Alright, so just positioning for my burn. Head back into the atmosphere. This is like the most easy maneuver in the world. Just bringing Bob and Jebediah home. And Bill, they're crying with excitement right now to be leaving the space station. They're the first Kerbonauts to successfully live in an orbit for a few days or months or however long they were up there, maybe even a year. I haven't left I haven't left Kerbin space yet, though. I've only gone to the moon and back. So not that much time has passed. There's just no way. Alright, he's birded back. I'm checking the map here. I edit all this out, to be honest. Boring. See, I'm already headed back in the atmosphere. I just cut everything out. Because it's like, all I'm doing is burning back towards the final retrograde burn. Not exciting. Alright, as soon as I hit the air, which is now my jettison. Because since I'm already in the air, that will slow down and hit the ground, it won't keep orbiting. Even though I think it would have hit the ground anyways because it was on my trajectory, so. But I like to jettison things in the atmosphere. Editing. Bill, Bob, coming home. Never ever will I build such a hard Oh, that space station gives me nightmares now to think about how hard I've had to work. Like, if stuff was more maneuverable and more symmetrical, these missions would have been so easy. Because I would have, I've learned the hard, let's put it this way, I'm a master pilot. If I can dock those unsymmetrical pieces of crap to each other, I must be an amazing pilot to be able to do that. Because if I had designed these ships properly, like I'll do with my interplanetary cruiser, which is my next space station. Touchdown. All right, next mission to Mun. I'm going to build a base on Mun. It's going to be like a test run for my modules for my interplanetary cruiser. So I'm going to practice by landing stuff on Mun. You'll see, it's going to be really cool. I've already started filming it. Anyways, yay.